35th meeting between these two teams. History is heavily weighted in the race's favour. Pirates have only won 6 times with 2 draws. The Scottish side have been successful on 26 occasions. They still have the best British player in the league of the races. He's Tony Hand, who you can guarantee will be among the top 5 scorers at the end of the season. In Ivan Matulik, they have an import tried and tested at this level. He was with the Sheffield Steelers last year, but came to the races to be with and play alongside best friend Mike Ware. It was pretty much all doom and gloom around these parts at the start of the season for the Pirates, but a 10-all tie against the Cardiff Devils a few weeks ago has brought a renewed air of confidence for a club who have in better times made it through to the Wembley Championships. Most of the good things they do surround Dale Jago, their captain. The referee for this game is Simon Kirkham. Pirates wearing white shirts and blue shorts, the Racers in red. And Dean Everston, who starts this game for the Racers, will know this rink well. One of his previous clubs was the Peterborough Pirates. Straight away it's Murrayfield who are making the move up the ice, looking for the man Matulik in front of net. There he is on the turn, on the spin, and he scores! That's only 13 seconds into the game, and the first move created by Dean Emerson. And there's obviously a good telepathy working between him and Ivan Matulik out in front of net, because the pass could hardly have been more inch-perfect. Tony Hand looking for it, didn't need to bring him into the play. The shot coming in from Matulik, and 13 seconds into the game, the Edinburgh Racers are a goal to the good. What a shock for the home fans, who've been very much silenced and quietened by that. So a few people have made their way down from Edinburgh for this game, aside from the players, and they will be looking for a rare victory on the road. Difficult to beat in Edinburgh, but they find life away from that great city very difficult indeed. That's Jeff Lindsay for the Peterborough Pirates. Back to him on defence again, just marshalling the front of net is Jason Porter. Away comes Lindsay. Lindsay through to Mark Salisbury. Salisbury just fanning on it. Ivan Matulik. Tony Hand, instrumental in just about everything Murrayfield do that is good. Deep within their own zone, that will go all the way through. An icing call, and they return back to the other end. A bit of skating for the linesman. It's Mr. Howard. Tony Hand in the face-off circle against Cam Plant. Long-range effort coming in from Mike Ware. Good sliding stop made by Simon Wren in the Pirates' net. It's going to be under quite a barrage of shots from the front men for the Murrayfield Racers in this game. That he knows. Now, here come the Pirates trying to make something happen with Dale Jago. They can't at the moment because Scott Plews has it. Around the ball to Dean Everston. Forward chases Ivan Matulik. He's got a real turn of speed on him. Matulik looking for the wraparound. Good stop by Wren. They'll need to bring it away quickly because there's still danger. Jago, down right wing. He's got Andy Steele if he wants to use him. Long range effort just testing out Morrie Hansen. And here come the Murrayfield defence. Turning defence into attack quickly with Hand. Trying to pick out Dean Emberston. He'll chase it around the back of net. No icing call this time. Andy Steele. Hunt from behind the back of his net. Icing call called by the bench before it was called by the linesman. And again, they come all the way back down to this end of the ice. Again, won by the Racers, who seem to be winning the majority of face-offs in this game. Jago, try and pick out Randy Smith. Doesn't succeed this time, but it's dumped back in. Danger should be averted by Lindsay. Jago just patrolling the front of the net in case there are any problems. There might well be, because they can't get it away. It's going to fall across the face of net. Richie Lamb is waiting for the pass, but now away they come with a good opportunity for the Pirates to make something. Randy Smith just testing out Morrie Hansen in the Murrayfield Racers net. And collect back on halfway. Jeff Lindsay. Run back though by the Racers. It's Laurie Dunbar. Shot ranging in on net from Richie Lamb. This line is causing a few headaches and a few problems for the Peterborough Pirates. Controlling the blue line, Stuart Carville, formerly of Medway Bears and Humberside Hawks, now with the Peterborough Pirates. A rather unhappy time early on. Thought about going to the Solihull Barons, but has stayed in Cambridgeshire. Here, Nimi. He's getting himself a bit tied up around the back of net. Randy Smith could see that, and then the shot coming on the turn, on the spin from Stuart Carville. That was good work. It was a blind shot, really. Just had to take a little bit of reaction on the backhand. And there was Maury Hansen to thwart him at the near pipe. Lindsay trying to win that face-off, but away again comes Mike Ware, the big defenceman for the Murrayfield Racers. Big hit just happening off the play. Ware will drive to the net. Thwarted this time. Tony Hand can't collect. Cam Plant. And now sets Jeff Lindsay on his way. Lindsay will find Scott Plews. The object of his attention very closely. Mike Ware. Ware gets the return pass. Tony Hand just testing out, as he does so often, the netminders from long range. And he doesn't often miss the target, Tony Hand. A little bit of afters here with Plant and Dean Edmiston. Not discussing what they're going to be doing after the game, I can assure you. Free and linesman just intercepting before any nastiness can ensue. And good stop made by the Peterborough Pirates netminder. Pirates still trailing by a goal to nil against the Racers. Tony Hand foraging forward. Just clearing the zone. There might be a bit of danger here, in fact, for the Racers. Scott Plews sees Tony Hand out of the corner of his eye, but can't give it away. That's going to be a hooking call for sure. Or certainly should be. But the referee has decided to let that one go. I find that quite amazing. About as blatant and as obvious as you could possibly see. And referee Simon Kirkham won't be getting any prizes from the home side for that. Ware might have turned that little bit of fortuitous play into attack. Away comes Randy Smith. Really buoyed up and fired up. Randy Smith can't get the shot away, and he's upended this time by Mike Ware. And this time, Simon Kirkham does call it. Well, that wasn't as blatant as the other one, but it was close to the net, I suppose, and did stop him from a goal-scoring opportunity. And Mike Ware is gone for 2 minutes. Cam Plant. Randy Smith peeling off to his right. Plant just dumping it in. Who wants to chase? Cassie Dawkins is the one closest to it, with Mark Salisbury for company. Racers will just get it as far away as possible from their own net. Dale Jago, knowing that this man advantage won't last forever, and they'll need to make something happen with it pretty soon. Cam Plant. There's Jago. Jago nearly took a tumble, but kept on his feet. Chance around the front of the net, still a scramble. Randy Smith, can he find Cam Plant? Plant's in a bit of space, so too is Smith. They need somebody to flood the net. Smith is the closest man to getting into that position. Dale Jago now, just being held off the play in front of net. Salisbury. Salisbury and Plews. Little wraparound is there. It's found its way through. Mark Salisbury, I think, will get the credit. Randy Smith will certainly get an assist on that. And on the power play, with a man advantage, the Peterborough Pirates make it count. Salisbury is the man. Randy Smith tried the wraparound. It was kicked out partially by Hansen. But there was Mark Salisbury, and he would not be budged or shifted from that front position. From a home side's point of view and home crowd's point of view, that's the sort of scoreline they would prefer to see. Let's see their side get a march over the Edinburgh Racers and get in front before the end of this period. But 1-1, certainly looking better than it was, even if that was a bit of a gift as far as the power play was concerned from Mike Ware. Lindsay is forward and still going forward. Stops in his tracks by Horansky. He hasn't given up on that yet. That's good tenacious work, but he'll have to clear the zone now as Jason Porter fires it back in. Pianimi looking for the pass. Said it's given to Horansky. Chasing into position on right wing was Laurie Dunbar. Shot just testing out the netminder. Coming in from all angles at him in the early stages of this game, apart from the one effort from Matulik in the early stages, he's been equal to them all. Stuart Carville is a man who's going to battle his way through to the puck if he can get there. He can't do on this occasion. And a face-off in a fortuitous and advantageous position for the Pirates. Randy Smith will try and win it. Got Salisbury waiting in behind him. Cam Plant, but away with a chance now as Dean Everston. It's a two-on-one break. Everston really should score. Gives it to Hand. Very unselfish play by the former Pirate. And Tony Hand racks up another goal to add to the, well, literally thousands he scored in the British Premier Division. Good interchange between Edmiston and Tony Hand. Takes up his position right in front of net. And from there, he just does not miss. 2-1 to the Edinburgh Racers against the Peterborough Pirates. We're looking to change that situation pretty quickly. Dale Jago, the shot coming in again from Salisbury, has scored the only goal so far for the Pirates. But again, they're getting caught on the break, but it's all too late. The end of 20 minutes play here at the East of England Ice Rink. And the Pirates trail the Racers 2-1. The second period of this British Premier Division match between the Peterborough Pirates and the Edinburgh, formerly Murrayfield Racers. And it's the Scots side who are 2-1 up after 20 minutes play. Deservedly so. Shot there from Carville. Not known as a forward generally, but has got a good shot on him when he wants to let one go. Jason Porter. Craig Britton is just hanging around the front of net in case there's a chance of picking up on anything loose. Tony Hand. Ivan Matulik back to Hand again. Those two working together very well. Mike Ware just taking an opportunity to let one rip, and fully in behind that was Simon Wren. He's picked up a lot of rubber tonight and is going to see a lot more heading towards him before the end of the evening, that's for certain. It was going wide anywhere, but he wasn't too certain about that and really couldn't have known from that angle. Craig Britton. It's the centre ice territory that's being won most of the time by the Edinburgh Racers. It's something that Cam Plant will try and change as quickly as he possibly can. Carville forcing it forward again, straddling the blue line is Craig Britton, but it's turned around for Matulik. Wherever Matulik is, Hand is not too far away with Edmiston. Trying to work their way into net, just wide from Mike Ware. It's line very, very effective indeed. Tony Hand into the corner. Won't want to be there and will want to release it pretty soon. Pensive looking crowd here at the East of England Ice Rink, wondering what twists and turns we're going to see in this game still yet. Andy Steele battling for it in the corner with Cam Plant. Pirates certainly tenacious at the moment, but unable to put too much together. Stephen Johnson just forcing the puck in range. Having said that, here he is on halfway. Pirates fans engrossed in this game, knowing that their side is showing better form of late than they did in the early stages of the season. That 10-10 tie people are still talking about over the Cardiff Devils just a few weeks ago. Andy Steele, forward goes Stephen Johnson. There's an offside position, but Murrayfield have got it back again. Now driving to the net. It's Ware with Matulik waiting in behind him. Matulik has it back. Tony Hand will take up his position in front of net. Dean Everston will help him out to give him the puck. Return the compliment, get Hand into an open position if he can. This time good defensive work, which is virtually undone, and then repaired by Stephen Johnson, who'll whack it down the ice. A little bit scrappy in centre ice, nobody able to take the control on the game and this move that they're looking for. Jago into the corner, Andy Steele will chase. Before he can get there, Scott Plews will clear. He knows precisely where Tony Hand will be and what Tony Hand can do. Let's one go from long range. And again, Simon Wren would have been bracing himself knowing what sort of shot was going to be heading his way from the Racers number 9. Another defence, that's right through everybody, and that's going to be possession now for the Pirates. Through the centre, just being nudged off the play was Jeff Lindsay. Does well to win it back, a chance opening in front, and there's the conversion made by Stuart Carvel. Talking about his defensive qualities and ability earlier on, now he gets the chance, the big, broad grin and smile on the face of Stuart Carvel as he puts it away, 4 minutes and 19 into the second period. A slightly delayed reaction as he waited to see whether Maury Hansen was going to pick up on that one. He didn't, and slotted into the bottom left-hand corner. 2-2. The assists will go to Jeff Lindsay and to Dale Jago. 2-2 then. And well, it's been a very tight game. The race is just on top, but now not in terms of the scoreline anymore. Aransky Been kicked around by Carville, who fancy a chance of getting another one before the night is out. Dumped in by young Laurie Dunbar, easily picked up by the netminder. And here's another product of the system the racers have had for a few years. Young Laurie Dunbar. Lindsay. Wide open ice to use if he wants to, but can't get the pass through to the man he's looking for. Pianimi nearly. Salisbury. Chasing onto it's Cassie Dawkins. And Dawkins will not be denied. A few more smiles on the faces now with that scoreline of 2-2 than there was a few minutes ago. Might be 3-2. Jago driving to the net. Randy Smith with a great opportunity. Just tied up in front of net. Salisbury was there also. Dawkins. Jago, the captain. Back of the cover to Dawkins again. Good opportunity, perhaps out in front for a long-range effort from Cam Plant. Too many bodies in the way to let it get all the way through, and the racers have a chance with a shot coming in from Richie Lamb. And immediately they turned stout defence into all-out attack. And Richie Lamb, top shelf, left-hand corner. Aim, fire, accuracy of the first order, and nothing this time Simon Wren can do about it. 3-2 to the Edinburgh Racers over the Peterborough Pirates, but the jockeying for position in this game is still too close to call in terms of who was going to steal the march over the other. Two draws in these teams. All their meetings now suddenly having it centralised, and Dean Everston has got that look on his face. As I say, I didn't like that very much. Shake of the head. Tony Hand, Matulik pinning off to his left. Still Tony Hand. Matulik, great skating, great finish nearly by Matulik. Stopped though by the goalie. And here come the Pirates. Into the corner for Stephen Johnson to chase on to. This time Scott Plews gets there first. Shot from Cam Plant. Or he has just succeeded in knocking his defenseman over rather than the man he was looking to do. It's an offside call. They'll have to come all the way back over the blue line. A little bit of a scuffle going on. And Lindsay's involved. And Mike Ware is also wanting to have his two penneth worth. Tony Hand is saying, don't bother, don't get involved. And it'll happen from that, with Dean Emerson getting a stick wrapped around him. Mike Ware coming in to protect his colleague, and Mike Ware wants to go for it with the big guns. Lindsay backs off. Tony Hand says, no, not necessary. Let's cool it, boys. Nonetheless, there's going to be players dispatched to the penalty box. Simon Kirkham just trying to sort it all out. Jeff Lindsay will depart. Mike Ware will go, and Dean Emberston will depart also. Lindsay just takes the steam off the visor. The captain of the Peterborough Pirates, Dale Jago, just having his two penneth worth, trying to find out exactly what the calls are. And the calls will involve Jeff Lindsay and Dean Emberston. Jago. It being a 4-on-4, there's lots of wide open ice, even on this rink, which is not one of the biggest in the country. Jago back off the players. Cam Plant. It's Randy Smith. Not had quite the influence on this game we might have liked at this stage. Dale Jago goes for a fly. Changing on the fly, but wishing he had wings at that point. Plant waiting back on the blue line. Randy Smith getting into position in front of net. Dale Jago just back off the play. Here he is again, just giving it away straight away to the captain of the Murrayfield Racers. You do not want to do that to Tony Hand on any occasion, especially when he's in the sort of mood he looks to be in tonight. Chance for Matulik, it's in! Despite the despairing lunge of Simon Wren, who thought he had it, then he hadn't got it. Ivan Matulik knew he hadn't got it, almost straight away by the reaction and the victory salute. Matulik control it with his skate, then his stick. And Simon Wren will be a bit annoyed with himself. It's one he should have snapped up fairly easily, but this time he lets it through his guard. And the Edinburgh Racers score their fourth of the evening, and for the first time there's a bit of daylight opening up between the two teams. A two goal advantage for Jock Hayes' side. Peterborough have shown they have the tenacity and the capability to work their way back into the match. Cam Plant will see if he can help his side out to do just that. All of a sudden, Maury Hansen not too aware where the puck was. Randy Smith knew exactly where it was. And Mike Ware just trying to help out with the defensive duties. But Peterborough still have it, and they still have a great chance. There's a great opportunity there. Hit Andy Steele. He's gone down, almost poleaxed. Jago on the turn. Jago again. And Maury Hansen is living a charmed life with his goal. It's all four down by in the back of the net. Salisbury in there. Pieniemi. Long range effort from Jago is still not cleared. And now it will be. The referee, though, has seen something on the play. It's a holding call from Simon Kirkham. And it's going to be Pieniemi who's going to go. Goodness me, how did that puck stay out of the net from going between the pipes of Maury Hansen? Somehow, some way. And Simon Kirkham's arm will go up any moment now. That's Pieniemi just taking his man down. A 2-minute power play for the Pirates. A lazy skate up the ice from Campline. It might prove dividend shot ranging in from Stuart Carville. Not this time. Very close and went. Well, it looked to be the right side, but Hansen did well to cover as much of the goal as he could. Opening there for Richie Lamb. He's already scored one tonight. Then a rocket coming in the other direction for Simon Wren to try and control. Did well to see it, really, because it came out a cluster of bodies. It's Randy Smith now. Smith showed the acceleration and the direction that the Pirates are looking for. No, he can't, because Mike Ware lets one go. Top shelf. And this time, Simon Wren had committed himself to the near pipe. I think he had the angle covered, but Ware just took aim. And from that angle, that is a very, very good shot indeed. No protection from Lindsay out front, who was looking for the ricochet to clear the danger. But it really had passed Simon Wren before he could do anything about it. 5-2 to the Racers. That silenced the home crowd. They were getting a little bit excited early on when things were tighter. But now there's a lot to do to pull this game round. Craig Bretton in there with the position. Randy Smith. Smith! Oh, there was a great chance for Bretton, who was tied up in front of net and just couldn't get the shot away that he was looking for. Tony Hand. Had a pound for every time we mentioned his name during the course of the game. Whether it's at the back or the front or in the centre of the ice, he's always there when he's needed. It's Horansky. Horansky there with Pieniemi. Peterborough just happy to clear. And they'll do it through Stuart Carville. Forward goes Craig Bretton, and the end of 40 minutes play, and not a period the Pirates will want to look back on with fondness. 5-2. A 3-1 second period may well have killed off the chances of the Peterborough Pirates achieving only their seventh victory over the Racers, because the Edinburgh side very much in control of the second period of play. And there's a lot of work now for Tony Hunter and his team to do to even get a point out of this game. But they have been shown to be a very good third period team of late, whereas perhaps earlier on in the season they were giving up in the last 20 minutes. And suddenly seem to find a little bit of extra impetus and effort to bring the game round when all seems lost. Certainly players like Stuart Carville, just in front of the net, won't be giving up on this just yet. He's already scored one tonight. He feels there might be more in the locker before the evening is out. Scott Plews forcing the puck in the direction of the Pirates' goal. Lindsay. Nobody in a white shirt ready to collect on that one. Mike Ware will go back towards his own goal. Maury Hansen patrolling the front of the net. Dean Everson gives it away. One back by the Pirates. Scrappy in centre ice from both sides. So wet by the looks of things, the ice at the moment as well, which might have some impact on the early stage of this game. Mike Ware trying to tie his man up there. Craig Bretton, who was looking for anything loose. Plant. Cam Plant works his way into goal. That's a lovely goal. That's a lovely goal by the Peterborough Pirates. That was well worked. Sort of thing that works time and time again in training, but put it into a game situation, doesn't always pay off. But wonderful work there by Cam Plant. And Dale Jago it is in front of net who gets the final touch. And this time the Racers' defence undone. Plenty of white shirts around to finish it off if Jago couldn't. 5-3. Lead back to 2. Come on is the cry from the Pirates bench. They've still got a chance in this game. They have. There's plenty of time. There's another 18 minutes to go in this match yet. Goals, as we know and have seen in previous weeks, can be scored very quickly in ice hockey. We scored at both ends, of course. Randy Smith. That's Richie Lamb. With Les Lovell just in front of net, just trying to make sure there's no route through to his netminder. Haransky. Dunbar. Lovell. Chase on again for Haransky. Jago will try and clear his lines. Hasn't managed it so far, so a bit more danger for the net of Simon Wren. And just touches it into the direction of Plant, who will get it over the blue line. Chase back for Pianemi. He's got wheels when he wants to go, and he's going down right wing at a rate of knots until he's stopped from getting any further by Randy Smith, who's a big man and hard to push off the puck. Here he is again, trying to set the play up with the chase on for Jeff Lindsay. Won't quite get there before the Murrayfield Racers, or Edinburgh Racers, as we should call them these days. Habits die hard. Think of them now as the Edinburgh Racers rather than Murrayfield. Still playing, of course, out of the Murrayfield ice rink in the city of Edinburgh. Lamb. That's Andy Steele. Jago. Jago with help if he wants it from Johnson. Doesn't use it this time and just carried it a little bit too far down the ice because they'll have to set the play up all the way back down their own end. This Peterborough rink has been refurbished. Just a couple of years ago it looked like no further ice hockey will be taking place here. Cassie Dawkins offside. It's shot away. Cam Plant just surveying the scene, wondering what his side have to do to get back on level terms. Jeff Lindsay. Bit of afters going on between Danny Boom and Dean Edmiston there. As Danny Boom tries to intercept, just flicks off the end of his stick. We'll go all the way back down the other end. Plant. Lindsay. The boards, Danny Boom. Doing well just to keep the puck in that zone. They need somebody to help them out, or else Tony Hand's going to bring it away for the Edinburgh Racers. He can skate sideways, backwards, inside out, wherever you want him to go, he'll be there. Petulik. This is the line that's caused most of the problems. Mike Ware. Ooh, he gave that a fair amount of stick. He wasn't holding back on that one. Simon Wren managed to get a piece of it. Chance out in front again for Ware, following through Edmiston. And this time it's the Pirates' goal that lives a bit of a charmed life. Double save made by Simon Wren, give him credit. Smith, Andy Smith. The centre this time, he's going to have to follow in his own pass. Mike Ware's going to make the clearance. Jago. Edmiston skating down right wing. We'll get the chance. So just hover around that blue line though, just in case there's any chance of an interception, which always can be in this game. If you don't get the firm connection on the pass that you're looking for. Mike Ware ricochets around the board. Nearly a chance opening up. Racers will clear. Chase on, here's Edmiston. Edmiston knows where he wants to put it. Can't put it there because Randy Smith stopped him from getting there. Goes across the face, still held in though by Plews. Now who wants it? Matulik does, Plews is there. Tony Hand going back onto the blue line. Change in personnel for the Pirates. And the crowd really getting into it now in the third period. Tony Hand Emerson out in front of net. Tony Hand trying to do all the work. Johnson trying to hold Matulik off the play. Big man to try and keep quiet though. Matulik with Ware back on the blue line. Plews as well. Edmiston, Hand, Matulik. Matulik intercepted this time by Cam Plant. Emerson thought something should have been called by Simon Kirkham by his reaction there, but nothing is. Mike Ware. Now here's a chance perhaps for Cassie Dawkins to make his name this evening. Here come the racers. Oh, nearly a chance in front of net for Laurie Dunbar with Stuart Carville nearly taking Horansky for a tumble. Andy Smith. Smith loses out this time. Away comes Cam Plant to his opposite number, Marco Pianimi. Jago with Smith for support. Now, can Smith do anything with Jago? They're getting a bit tight to the right-hand board. It gives Horansky a chance to give a little bit of breathing space to the Edinburgh racers, and he will follow that puck down right wing. The call is made by the referee, and it'll be a power play. Racers trying to set it up with Tony Hand waiting for it on the blue line. He'll now follow it in, and another call made by the referee, this time much to the delight of the home fans. And Dean Emerson is the man who rather wearily makes his way to the penalty box. He's gone for slashing for 2 minutes. So, after the interference call on Cam Plant, now a slashing call made on Dean Emerson. And just about 10 minutes to go in this game. Still, could be anybody's game, but Racers seemingly have the march over the Pirates at this stage. We've seen in this game, it can transform itself rather quickly. Ware around the boards, Lindsay just keeping an eye on it. Shot then coming in, and it's Ivan Matulik again. With 10:13 gone on the clock for the third period. He makes it look so easy, doesn't he, from that sort of range and at that sort of angle. Simon Renner will be thinking just that. Why didn't I have that covered better? Well, perhaps it came as a quick release. And again, it did get a deflection off the goalie into the back of the net. Another one that perhaps he may feel he could have done better with, should have done better with, under the body before he had a chance to react. 6-3 then to the Racers. And now it's a very long climb back up for the Peterborough Pirates. They won't give up. Not that type of team. They've shown that already this season. Tony Hand. Forward it goes with a chance again for Matulik, who this time fans on it and just takes the goalie out as he does. I think Simon Wren might be feeling that for a little while, but Matulik this time knew what he wanted to do and just played a complete air shot on it. Took goalie and goal with him as he went. Jago. It's Randy Smith. Yep. Andy Steele. Rockets one off the boards. Following in is Cam Plant. Chance out in front of net. Good 1-2 for Dale Jago, and it's through. Stephen Johnson gets the final touch to put it in the back of the net. And they worked very hard on that. And we were talking about them not giving up. Good indication on that move that they're not prepared to lay down and die and have their bellies tickled at this stage in a bit of climbing. Goodness me. There was a lot of vaulting there, but in the end, Stephen Johnson, without too much histrionics, just knocks it in. And the Pirates fans, young and old, celebrate. Just control your enthusiasm, young lad. You've got a bit of time yet to go in this game. Mike Ware will clear the puck up the ice for a chance, perhaps, for Horansky. Tony Hand just lets it going behind him, and here's Johnson with Steele. Jago's there as well. That's a poor pass across. Not quite sure what he was intending to do there, but whatever it was, it didn't work out to their advantage. Matulik. Still Matulik. Almost got it to Hand, but not quite. Plews. Murrayfield would be happy just to hold on to this now. The Racers have got the points in the bag. Time is rapidly running out. Not long to go now before a couple of points on the road for Jock Hayes' side. No real urgency as the game comes towards its conclusion. Johnson just playing it around the boards. Mike Ware looking too keen to do too much with it either on the blue line. Last few seconds, Randy Smith. Now he might like to take a bullet from long range and does, and just wide of the target, ricochets back of the net. A little bit of afters going on left wing, involving Tony Hand and Randy Smith. And also, perhaps now with Pianini, Tony Hand and Mike Ware just looking daggers at Randy Smith, communicating in Canuck. And Ware and Randy Smith look like they're going to go for it for a moment. Last few seconds of the game, and the Racers have the points in the bag. Dean Emberson just huffing the puck on its way towards the Pirates net, and that's it. And although the Pirates have won the third period by 2-1, the score that matters is on your screen. The Racers have won.
What could have been for the Pirates? A few too many squandered chances, especially on the power play. Peterborough actually outshot Edinburgh 41-38. Racers captain Tony Hand was in prime form with 1+3 and was delighted with their first league victory.
You've got to be happy, you get 2 points in the road. We haven't been renowned for being a road team, but we took a few points in the road just now, so we're happy to get 2 points after. It was a long bus trip down here. And the small rink doesn't really suit our style of play, but we played well defensively. And when you come to other teams' rinks, you have to do a lot more defensive work than what we used to do. We used to be five guys up and try and score as many as possible, and hopefully never scored as many. And that doesn't work anymore. So we're having to play a little bit more defensively and just sort of just try and read the play a little bit more. But I say we got the goals tonight at the right time, and took the 2 points.
I think we're going for bigger and better things, and I'm talking about a playoff spot. I don't think that's out of the question. And with the guys we have, the character we have in this hockey team, we've got Dale Jago, who, in my opinion, is the best defenseman import in the league right now, and Randy Smith's proving that he's probably the best forward import in the league right now. Those guys are going to carry a lot of clout this year. We get Barber going again, and anything can happen. You got to make your own breaks, and sometimes we're having a tough time getting those breaks and capitalizing on them. We've got to take credit for our own wins and our own losses, and I think that the substance is there, and we've been working very hard. It's only a matter of time before we come through with it.